Thank you, Sudhir. Good morning to all the delegates. Chief Guest Mr. H.R. Khan represents Reserve Bank of India, the backbone of financial system. Guest of honor, Mr. A.P. Hota, Managing Director and CEO, National Payment Corporation of India. Mr. M.S. Raghavan, Chairman and Managing Director, IDBI Bank Limited. Mr. Arnab Basu, Technology Lead, PricewaterhouseCoopers. Sandeep Vachani, Head Major Conferences, CII. When I'm addressing you 5 years back on February 2010, when first time iPad was launched in US, and I saw the picture of the iPad sometime in April when I was visiting there. If I look at it just a 5 years, which happened when first iPad was just launched and today, it's not a long time as such. But entire industry has shifted from workstation notebooks to iPad to the mobile. And that shift has happened month on month, and the acceleration has happened so fast that we need to pick up the same word digital which the computer industry started from. In 1970s when we used to call digital computer. After 40 years I am using again the same word called digital in a different context. So somebody asked me the question, is that 1970 digital is different from 2015 digital? Because digital is the way the computer was designed for. And I think what vision in 1970s the people put together, I think has come to reality in 2015. And that's where we are in that fortunate era when we are watching the change in front of our eyes, the change which is happening, which was so dominant was with the currencies at one point of time, is now getting translated to a payment systems which are across mobiles, across various devices, and that is making the digital here and now agenda for us to discuss. And that's why we choose on the topic how digital is creating the differentiation over here. This platform has been created where we bring user of technologies and provider of the technologies, the banks and the consumers. So three of the things which is three stakeholder, the person who is using it, the provider who is doing it, and one of the technologies provider of it, bank, technology provider. And in that context, we need to have a dialogue over here. We choose the format this time that let's have a round table among all the stakeholders in the beginning, understanding, and that could be facilitated by independent person from ET now. Faye D'Souza will be facilitating that round table. Then it will be followed by a three plenary session we divided, how digital is revolutionizing the banking. Second is how the payments are creating a differentiation, because underlying thing of the digital is payment and accelerating the payments. And third thing is what are the gray areas in the entire various shades of the banking which is there, or what are the negative side, what we need to watch for, and all those things need to be observed in that area. So three sides of the digital, so four sessions are critically important, with a foundational session of where we listen to the key speaker like Mr. Khan, Mr. Raghavan, Mr. Hota, that what their perspective of the digital is all about. A lot of times the question is asked, what is digital? Is digital means quantifiable financial benefit to the consumer? What is that quantifiable financial benefit can be there? Can you quantify that a bank will save X amount of money because it goes digital? So let's say branch which is operated with average of 7 people branch, can it be operated with 6 people branch using digital? So if there are 1,000 branches and there is a save of 1 person per branch can be reduced, then 1,000 jobs can be saved by the using digital, or 1,000 jobs can be deployed for serving the customer better. So on saving side, if average cost of the employee is 3 lakh rupees per annum and 1,000 branches there, 3 lakh into 1,000, it could be a save of 30 crore. But it's not a save of 30 crore, but 30 crore investment can go into the customer relationship and customer retention area, then So it could be quantifiable benefit. Second quantifiable benefit could be, can we convert more people to a primary customer of the bank rather than becoming the account holder of the bank? The whole race today is going towards acquiring customer and loyalty behind it. In banking system, this was loyalty was before. Our loyalty in banking system is generation to generation. Where my father opened account, my account will remain in the same bank. So it's a loyalty, is generational loyalty. Now today, Flipkart or e-commerce companies are searching for the loyalty, which is few years of loyalty. And how do you make those loyalty converted into the actual transactions and number of active customers what the bank has is phenomenally important, because the decision making power, when it comes to the fingertip, the decisions become much, much faster for somebody to execute. And that's where the acceleration is going to happen in a quantifiable benefit. Can I improve my primary customer base by 20%? And if I make 1 lakh profit per customer per year as a NIM on the deposits, or whatever the number, $100, 5,000 rupees I make a profit per customer, can that be increased to 6,000 rupees per customer? And if I have a X million customer and 1,000 rupees is added to that, that becomes my incremental margin to be invested into it. So translating digital into quantifiable financial benefit, I would say, could be the focus when we are having a various conversation over here, that what each digital technology can translate the benefit to the various banks, make it more frictionless from the operational perspective, and reducing risk, including the cost of KYC or regulation issues which are there. We call it issues. To me, regulation is not an issue. Regulation is a fundamental infrastructure to support the smoothness of the transaction. And that infrastructure has to deal with risk equally important as the customer experience is all about. So there are 7 elements, I would say, which are most important for digital platform. First is your customer experience, which we all know, and a lot of us emphasize on UX and UI part of it. Second is how it translates into the operational excellence. Third is how is giving a performance to the entire system, the end-to-end transaction capabilities, how it is helping analytics to be doing better, how it is preventing the risk, how it is integrating together, how this infrastructure of the Reserve Bank of India, National Payment Corporation of India, the various banks, the various payment banks which will come together, how will they form the total integration into the system and how it will be secured. So these are 7 elements. COPARIS, we call it, customer experience, operations, performance, analytics, risk, integration, and security. So once this structure becomes complete under the 7 players come together, today is a day when we are looking at it, how various players like Microsoft or SAP would play role in providing the technologies for that. Player like Infrasoft, Intellect, or other product companies will provide solutions for that. How the banking system will work together with that, and how the regulators will play the role. So today on the dais, we have the representative. Fortunately, we could able to get most of the representative which is required for this dialogue to happen. And that dialogue will be so concrete because we have a real hands-on people. Either they define the policy, they govern the policies, or the people who drive the technology to those policies. And I think that is the power of CII. I must appreciate they put the things together, CII and PwC, when we met together a few months back and defined the agenda. I think in last 5 months of our efforts, we are able to put together the right topics, the right team, which can discuss throughout the day what outcome can be there from this meeting. So I expect a lot of outcome from this session in terms of concrete, actionable, which can drive quantifiable benefits to the consumer, to the banks, to the economy as a overall. Ladies and gentlemen, I once again thank you for a wonderful audience and look forward to joining the interesting deliberations along with you during the day today. I would request, even if you make a note, some questions are not answered during the session because session will have a limited time sometime. Give the questions to the central desk We will keep the forum open of this digital banking of CII and bank tech, where we can continuously create a Facebook group where we can discuss what are the issues which are coming in. So keep noting down the question on your pads, and CII, Sandeep can collect this question, and even Arnab can collect this question. We can just keep responding to them, because one day is not sufficient for various questions to be answered, and some of the questions we may not have answered at all in this workshop. It's only a one-day workshop available. And all your ideas, if you can start sharing into that kind of a Facebook session, could be very, very interesting for us to know about it. Thank you very much.